Good morning, students. Today we will discuss about 8086 microprocessors. In the last lectures, we have already completed the discussion with 8085 microprocessors, the peripherals 8255 PPI. And now today we will start about 8086 microprocessor. So all we know the definition of microprocessor that we have discussed in the earlier classes or lectures. That microprocessor is a clock-driven electronics device which can perform some arithmetic and logical operation, and it has its own internal memory. And the evolution of the microprocessor that also we have discussed in the earlier classes, that in 1971 Intel introduced its first 4-bit microprocessor 4004. In 1972, 8-bit microprocessor has been invented by the Intel. In 1974, 8-bit microprocessor 8080, that is a general purpose microprocessor, was invented. And in 1978, 16-bit microprocessor, that is 8086 and 8088, that was invented in 1978. In 1974 also, 8085 microprocessor was invented, that we have discussed in the earlier classes. Now, what are the limitations of 8085 microprocessor? The number one, the low speed. Number two, the low memory addressing capability. Number three, limited number of general purpose register. Number four, less powerful instruction set. All these limitations are reduced in 8086 microprocessor. The peripheral chip designed earlier for 8085 were compatible with microprocessor 8086 with slight or no modifications. Now we will discuss about the register organization of 8086 microprocessor. The register organization of 8086 microprocessor. In the 8085 microprocessor, we all know there are some 8-bit registers and two 16-bit registers also. Like 8-bit registers are accumulator B, C, D, E, H, L, and the 16-bit registers are stack pointer, program counter, and sometimes the register B, C or D, E or H, L can be used as a register pair, like B register pair, D register pair or H register pair. Okay, and the stack pointer that is related with the stack, and program counter always hold the address of the next instruction to be executed. That also everything we have discussed in the 8085 microprocessor instruction set, register organization of 8085 microprocessor. Similarly, now we will discuss about the register organization of 8086 microprocessor. Okay, so all the registers of the 8086 microprocessor has been divided into two parts, general purpose register and special purpose register. So before starting this part, one thing that I want to tell you, that as we know, 8085 was 8-bit microprocessor because 8085 at a time can access maximum 8-bit data at a time, and the data bus of the 8085 microprocessor was 8-bit and address bus of the 8085 microprocessor was 16-bit. Okay, and now for the 8086 microprocessor, the data bus is 16-bit. It is 16-bit microprocessor because 8086 microprocessor at a time can access maximum 16-bit of data, and the address bus of 8086 is 20-bit. Okay, address bus of 8086 is 20-bit. So as simple as the memory calculation, for 8085, maximum 64 kilobyte memory can be accessed by the 8085 microprocessor, that we have discussed and we have calculated also. Similarly, for 8086, maximum 1 megabyte of memory can be attached with the 8086 microprocessor. Okay, so this is the basic information about the 8086 microprocessor. It is 16-bit processor because 8086 microprocessor at any time can access 16-bit data. So data bus is required for 8086 is 16-bit and address bus is 20-bit. Now we come back to the register organization of 8086 microprocessor. So all the 16-bit registers of 8086 microprocessor has been divided into basically two parts. One is general purpose register and another is special purpose register. Now here we can come some basic information about the general purpose register and the special purpose registers. Okay, the general purpose register can be used for holding data, variables and intermediate results temporarily or for other purposes like a counter. The special purpose register are used as segment register, pointer, index registers or as offset storage registers. All the different type of registers individually we can discuss later in the next in a further discussion of this lecture. Okay, so we now come back to the particular diagram. The register AX, that is 16-bit register, BX, another 16-bit register, CX, DX. There are four 16-bit register. These are the general data register or general purpose registers. Okay, AX can be divided into two parts, AH and AL. AL and H both are individually 8-bit register. AL is 8-bit, it is a 8-bit, and AH another individually is 8-bit, and simultaneously it can be considered as a AX, that is the 16-bit register, and it is called the accumulator. Similarly, BX is a 16-bit register, or it can be divided in two parts, 8-bit and another 8-bit, that is the BL, BH. Here L define the lower byte and H define the higher byte. As simple as that, CX divided in two parts, CL and CH, C lower part, C higher part, or higher byte, C lower byte, CH higher byte, DX, D lower byte, and DH is the D higher byte. So AX is the accumulator, BX is the base register, CX is the counter, can be considered as a counter in some program of 8086 microprocessor. DX can be used as a data register, can be used to hold the data. So these are called general data register or data group registers. Now we can come to some another four different registers called CS, code segment register, SS, stack segment registers, DS, data segment register, ES, extra segment register. So what are the function of different register, that also we can discuss later. So these are called the segment registers. Okay, so now next we come to that part, that is the SP or the stack pointer, BP the base pointer, SI source index register, DI base trace index registers. And remember, all the registers are 16-bit registers. Okay, stack pointer SP, base pointer SI source index, DI base trace index, and all these are called the pointer and index group register. Okay, now come to another registers called the IP, the instruction pointer, and the definitely the flag register. And flag registers, there is 16-bit flag register also divided in two parts, that is the flag lower byte and the flag higher byte. Okay, it is called the flag or PSW. You know what is PSW? That is the program status word. In the 8086 microprocessor, there are also PSW, that is accumulator and flag simultaneously considered as a PSW. So here PSW is program status word, that is related with the flag register only. It's called the flag or the PSW. And these two registers belongs to process control group. That means there are basically four different type of group of registers, that is general data registers, segment registers, pointer index registers, and process control group registers. General data registers belongs to general purpose registers that we have discussed in the earlier cases, general purpose register. Okay, and in the special purpose register, that belongs segment registers, pointer index group registers, and process control group registers. Okay, now the AX, BX, CX, DX, and IP instruction pointer, that also we have discussed in the earlier, that is AX define AH and AL, BX define BH and BL, CX define CH and CL, DX define DH and DL, etc. Okay, now come to the segment registers. That is the code segment register, data segment register, extra segment register, and the stack segment register. Okay, 8086 microprocessor can address maximum 1 megabyte of
memory
that we have discussed earlier, that as per the common procedure of 8085 microprocessor memory calculation, we can calculate the maximum memory which can be attached with the 8086 microprocessor. Okay, and we know that 64 kilobyte memory can be attached with 8085 microprocessor. Similarly, we can calculate that 1 megabyte memory maximum can be attached with the 8086 microprocessor. So this memory, that is the 1 MB memory, that is the 1 megabyte of memory, is divided into 16 logical segment. Okay, total 1 MB memory is divided into 16 logical segment. So each segment contain 64 kilobyte of memory. Each segment contain 64 kilobyte of memory. Total 1 MB memory has been divided into total 16 logical segment. So each logical segment consists 64 kilobyte memory, each logical segment. So there are 4 segment registers actually. Okay, there are 4 segment registers actually. That is the code segment register, data segment registers, extra segment registers, and stack segment registers. First, we come to the code segment register. Code segment register is used for addressing a memory location in the code segment of the memory where the executable program is stored. So whenever one particular program is written in this microprocessor and stored into the memory, that is in the RAM basically, then depending upon the different part of the program, that is means any program contains the data, any program can contain the stack, data of the stack, any program can contain the address. In this way, any program can contain only the code, having accessible code or opcode, something like that. So in a particular program, different part will be stored into the different segment, and that is hold by the different segment registers. Similarly, code segment registers hold the that particular part of the memory location where the code is loaded, executable program is stored. Okay, so the code segment register used for addressing a memory location in the code segment of the memory, where the executable program is stored. Next, the data segment register. In the data segment register points to the data segment of the memory where the data is stored. Simple. Data segment register, it points where the data is stored or data is resides. Extra segment register. Extra segment register also contains the data. It referred to the another essentiality data segment of the memory. Okay, that means extra segment registers also can contain the data itself, like the data segment registers. And the stack segment register, definitely it is related with the stack of a particular program. So stack segment register is used for addressing stack segment of the memory, that is the memory which is used to store the data, so there is the part of the segment register. Okay, so code segment, data segment, extra segment, and stack segment. And utility of the different segment registers, that means how it can be used in 8086 microprocessor addressing, that we can discuss in the later discussion. Okay, now we come to the pointer and index register. In the pointer and index register group, there are base pointer, stack pointer that we have already discussed. Stack pointer is directly related with the stack. Stack pointer always hold the address of the top of the stack. The base pointer, source index, destination index, okay, and instruction pointer. So what are the pointers and index register of the 8086 microprocessor? The 8086 has two number of pointer register, stack pointer and base pointer. The stack pointer that we have discussed earlier case, the base pointer register is similar to the BX register of the 8086 microprocessor. We will generally use this register to access parameters and local variable in a particular procedure. Okay, the base pointer also is similar to the BX registers, and it can be used for physical memory calculation, and we'll come for the physical memory calculation lecture. So base pointer is almost equal to the BX register, the 16-bit register of the 8086 microprocessor. Okay, the stack pointer register maintains the program stack. Normally, we would not use this register for arithmetic computation. The stack pointer and base pointer register are used to access data in the stack segment of the memory. The stack pointer is automatically updated on execution of pop or push instructions. The base pointer contains the offset address in the current stack segment, that is the SS, stack segment register. The 8080 or 8085 program counter is called the instruction pointer. In 8080 microprocessor, we know there is a particular register called the program counter. Program counter always hold the next instruction to be executed. Similarly, in the 8086 microprocessor, there is a register called the instruction pointer that is almost equal to the program counter in 8086 microprocessor. Program counter in 8086 microprocessor almost equal to the instruction pointer of the 8086 microprocessor. Here, instruction pointer always hold the address of the next instruction to be executed. The 8086 has the number of index register, that is the source index register and the destination index registers. The index registers are used to access physical data from data segment or extra segment registers. They may be used in 16-bit arithmetic or logical operations. We may use this register as pointer to indirectly access the memory. The source index register and destination register sometimes can be used to execute a particular program from upper to lower part or lower to upper part. I mean, it can also change the direction of flow of the execution. In 8085 microprocessor, program always will be executed in a particular one direction. In 8086 microprocessor, the direction of the program can also be changed from upper to lower or from lower to upper. The source index register and destination index registers always hold the particular address of the program, the starting of the program. Okay, now we will discuss about the very important part of the 8086 microprocessor system, that is the 80 that is the flag register. We know that flag register for 8085 microprocessor, the flag register was 8-bit flag registers, and different flag can be used to find out the status of the particular data after any arithmetic and logical operation. So in 8085 microprocessor, after any arithmetic and logical operation, the data will be stored into the accumulator and the status of the data will be stored into the flag register. Okay, according to the different status of the flag, result, that means whether the result is negative or positive, whether the result is zero or non-zero, whether carry has been generated or not, whether parity is even or odd. In this way, the status of the result would be stored into the flag register in 8086 microprocessor also. Similarly, the 8086 microprocessor, there is a flag register, but the flag register capacity is 16-bit. Flag register capacity is 16-bit. So here we simple write down the different flag B0, B1, B2, B3 up to B15. So B0 to B7, this is the lower byte of the flag register, and B8 to B15, this is the higher byte of the flag registers. And now we can discuss the different flag of 8086 microprocessor. Initially, for the lower byte of the flag, that is similar with the flag of the 8085 microprocessor, that is from the LSB, from the B0, that is the carry, don't care, parity, don't care, auxiliary, don't care, 0 bit and signed bit. So we know what are the function of different flag, okay, because these are the similar with the 8085 microprocessor also. And for the 8086 microprocessor, another 4 different bits are new, that is the T, I, D and O. The T define the trap flag, I define the interrupt flag, D defines the direction flag, and O defines the overflow flag. Okay, so as a normal consequence, we simply discuss each flag. Okay, so starting from the carry flag, we know that the carry, after any arithmetic and logical operation, if carry has been generated, then that bit is only 1. If carry will not be generated, so that bit will be 0. Okay, here 1 stand for true, and 0 stand for false, as simple as the 8085 microprocessor flag register. Okay, for the carry flag, again we can tell you, for the carry flag, the flag is set, means 1, if there is a carry out of MSB in an add instruction or an arithmetic instruction, or a borrow is generated in a sub instruction or subtraction, otherwise it is 0, means reset. Okay, parity flag. For the parity flag, the flag is set, means the flag will be 1 if the result of an arithmetic or logical operation, the result in an even number of 1 bit, okay, otherwise it is closed. That means in the result, if the total number of count of 1 is even, then that bit will be 1, otherwise that bit will be 0. Okay, parity flag. Okay, auxiliary carry flag. Auxiliary carry is very simple. After 1 nibble, if carry has been generated, so auxiliary carry will be generated, means it will be 1. If not, then it will be 0. Auxiliary carry means after from the LSB, after 4 bit, if carry has been generated, means after 1 nibble, carry has been generated, it is called the auxiliary carry. So if auxiliary carry has been generated, it will be 1. If not, it is 0. Zero flag, if result is 0, then the bit is 1. If result is not 0, the bit is 0, because 1 stands for true and 0 stands for false. So name of the bit is 0 bit. So if result is 0, after any subtraction, if result is 0, so condition is true, that means that bit will be 1. If there is no 0, non-zero result is there, so that bit will be 0. Sign flag, 1 stands for negative and 0 stands for positive. If the result is negative, the sign bit will be 1. If the result is positive, sign bit will be 0. Okay, now next, the trap flag. The trap flag is a new one flag. The trap flag is a new one flag. Okay, the trap flag, if this flag is set, the 8086 enters the single instruction mode. The process executes the current instruction and the control is transferred to the trap interrupt. We know the trap interrupt is the highest priority interrupt in the 8085 microprocessor set. In the 8085 microprocessor, we have already discussed about the interrupt part. So in the interrupt part, trap is the highest priority interrupt. Okay, so in the case, if the highest priority interrupt has been activated, so definitely the trap flag will be 1. If not, then trap flag will be 0. Okay, so in this mode, the 8086 generates an external interrupt after execution of each instruction. Okay, the user can debug the program using trap flag. Okay, that is the utility of the trap flag. Now come to the interrupt flag. It is very simple. If this flag is set, mean if this flag is 1, the external maskable interrupt is enabled. If clean, meaning if it is 0, then interrupt are the disabled. Okay, so whether the interrupt are enabled or not, that is defined by this interrupt flag. 1 for the true and 0 for the false. Okay, direction flag. Okay, if this flag is set, means if the flag is 1, then the content of the index registers, that is the source index registers and destination index register, the post index registers, will be decremented after each operation. Once for byte operation and twice for the word operation. Okay, 2 byte means 1 word. And if the flag is clean, mean if the flag is 0, if the flag is 0, the register will be incremented once for byte operation and twice for the word operation. Okay, so very simple. It will be decremented for 1 byte operation for the source index registers and destination index register. If the bit is 1, it will be decremented, and if direction flag is 0, that means the index registers will be incremented. Okay, 1 for decremented of SI and DI content, and 0 means incremented the content of SI and DI. Now it comes to the overflow flag. Now it's come to the overflow flag. That is the this flag is set, means that if that flag is 1, then the operation result is an overflow. Overflow means that is the size of the signed operation exceed the capacity of the destination register. Okay, every destination register has the particular capacity, but if there is a signed operation, so extra 1 bit will be added for the signed operation, 1 for the negative value and 0 for the positive value in the MSB. then the value, if we want to load this data, signed operation, signed value into the particular destination folder, destination register, so it will be overflow. So then that bit will be 1. Okay, that means this flag is set if the operation result is an overflow, that is the size of the signed operation exceed the capacity of the destination register. And interrupt overflow instruction is available that will generate an interrupt in this situation. Okay, so these are the overflow bit, and other bits are don't care. So you have to remember only the four flag: the trap flag, interrupt flag, direction flag, and overflow flag. And all other flag are bits are the as same as 8085 microprocessor flag. So this all about the flag registers and other registers of 8085 microprocessors also. So that is the basic introduction of 8085 microprocessor, the basic register set or register organization of 8085 microprocessor, all our 16-bit registers, and the data bus also 16-bit, address bus also 20-bit, maximum 1 megabyte address can be connected, memory can be connected with the 8085 microprocessor IC. Okay, so there is a general purpose register, just simple as the in 8085 there is accumulator B, C, D, E, H, L in the accumulator, in the flag register in 8085 microprocessor. As simple as the in 8086 microprocessor, the registers are AX, BX, CX and TX. Sometimes we can use as a 16-bit register, but if we want to use as a normal 8-bit registers, that we can use AL or AH, BL or BH, etc, etc. Okay, and there are some segment registers for the code segment, stack segment, data segment, extra segment. These segment registers can be used to physical address calculation, and the in the program the different part, the code, the data of the stack, etc, can be stored into different segment registers. Okay, and in the pointer registers also there, the instruction pointer is related with the program counter of 8085 microprocessor, and the instruction pointer as simple as the in 8086 microprocessor, the flag register that belongs to process control group. Okay, and in the pointer index control group there are four registers are there: stack pointer, base pointer, source index and destination index. So these are the simple register organization of 8086 microprocessor, including the flag registers also. Okay, so thank you.